Let's go to Hagrid's now! We should be going.
What are we doing hanging around here? Can we go now?
We'll stay here.
We need to go. Hurry up! Hagrid needs us!
Was that the unsheathing of a blade I heard?
Shouldn't we be there by now? Come on, let's go see Hagrid. Can we go now?
As Harry, Ron, and Hermione arrived at Hagrid's hut, the executioner came to seal Buckbeak's fate.
He's here. Don't let him see you.
How could they?
Scabbers!
It's okay, Scabbers. Come back.
Ah, gotcha! Ow!
Ron was dragged into the whomping willow. Harry and Hermione chased after him.
You God, I am trapped.
That's great, thanks.
Thank you.
The tunnel from the Whomping Willow led into the Shrieking Shack. Harry discovered that the black dog was in fact Sirius Black, and that Black had not been trying to murder him, but had in fact been hunting down Peter Pettigrew. The man that had truly betrayed Harry's parents to Lord Voldemort. As they marched Pettigrew to Hogwarts, the full moon rose, and Professor Lupin transformed into a werewolf.
Lily! Take him!
Now captured, Sirius Black awaited his fate on the seventh floor of the West Tower. Harry and Hermione awoke in the hospital wing, eager to explain to Dumbledore what had happened.
Professor! Black's telling the truth!
He's innocent, Professor!
I believe everything you say, but there is nothing I can do. What we need is more time.
Hermione understood immediately. Dumbledore was giving them permission to use the time turner she'd been using all year to attend several lessons at once.
We're going to use the time turner to go back 3 hours, rescue Buckbeak, and then save Sirius.
Having rescued Buckbeak, Harry and Hermione hid amongst the bushes beside the lake. As the moment drew closer to Black's capture by the Dementors, Harry's mind wrestled with the vision of the shadowy figure and the ghostly creature that he had seen by the lakeside.
I know it sounds crazy, but I think it was
Harry,
my dad.
You mustn't be seen.
It was time for the rescuer to appear, but no one was coming to help this time. And then it hit him. He had not seen his father. He had seen himself.
I've got to save them!
Take him!
I know, but they'll soon be coming to take him to the tower. We've got to hide. Do you reckon Sirius is up there yet?
Who's that coming out of the castle?
McNair, the executioner. He's gone to fetch the Dementors. One of us has got to get Buckbeak to that tower.
Hurry up! The Dementors are coming!
How can I ever thank?
Get on! There's not much time! The Dementors are coming! Go!
We'll see each other again. You truly are your father's son, Harry.
Nobody at Hogwarts knew the truth behind what had happened the night that Sirius, Buckbeak and Pettigrew had vanished, except Harry, Hermione, Professor Dumbledore and Ron.
I trust that you will make the best of the last day of term to say your goodbyes for another year, and to do anything that remains to be done. I'll remind you that we will soon hold the House Cup ceremony. But if you would like to run along now, come back to me when you're ready to see who's won.